The US and the Philippines reaffirmed their commitment to operating in the South China Sea, conducting joint military exercises and patrols to assert their stance against China's territorial claims. This move, alongside a significant $500 million investment in regional defense, aims to deter potential aggression. Additionally, a US Air Force investigation revealed that a catastrophic failure in an aircraft's gearbox led to an unrecoverable crash off Japan, killing 8 airmen, underscoring the importance of these defense initiatives. China's foreign ministry announced sanctions against US lawmaker Jim McGovern, prohibiting him and his family from entering China and banning all transactions with him. This move comes in response to McGovern's frequent criticisms of China's policies, reflecting ongoing diplomatic tensions between the two nations. The European market for Chinese electric vehicles, EVs, surged in response to anticipated tariff hikes by the European Union. In June alone, approximately 23,000 Chinese EVs were registered in Europe, marking a 72% increase from the previous month. This rush was driven by EU plans to impose extra duties of up to 37.6% on Chinese EV imports, highlighting the complex dynamics of international trade and the impact of protectionist policies. Concurrently, the US faces resistance from its allies over its stringent restrictions on semiconductor exports to China. These restrictions have raised concerns among industry players and allied nations, who argue that decoupling from China could harm global supply chains and economic stability. Notably, the Dutch government has expressed its willingness to maintain practical bilateral relations with China despite US pressures. China's prominent role in artificial intelligence was showcased at the World Artificial Intelligence Conference. The event emphasized China's contributions to global AI governance and highlighted the country's efforts in strengthening international cooperation in AI capacity building. This is further underscored by China's pioneering efforts in developing the world's first 6G field test network, led by Jiang Ping from the Beijing University of Posts and Telecommunications. The network demonstrated the feasibility of achieving 6G transmission capabilities on 4G and 5G technologies, marking a significant leap in telecommunications. Indonesia's high-speed railway between Jakarta and Bandung, known as WUSH, has successfully transported 4 million passengers since its commercial launch on October 17, 2023. The railway, which connects the two cities in just 40 minutes, has significantly boosted regional connectivity and economic growth, reflecting the positive impact of infrastructure projects. A recent accident involving a driverless ride-hailing vehicle has sparked debates about the safety and reliability of autonomous driving technology. Analysts noted that while autonomous technology theoretically improves road safety, practical challenges remain due to complex road conditions. Despite these challenges, industry observers remain optimistic about the future prospects of driverless ride-hailing services, given ongoing technological advancements and policy support. The economic significance of Chinese seaports continues to grow, with the added value of the port economy in China's 59 seaport cities reaching 6.2 trillion yuan, $869.05 billion, in 2023. This accounted for 13.4% of the total economic output of these cities, with the Yangtze River Delta region contributing 44.7% of the total. These figures underscore the pivotal role of seaports in China's economic landscape. China's strategic partnerships with Russia and Cuba have intensified, as evidenced by recent military and intelligence operations aimed at countering US influence. The interception of Russian and Chinese military aircraft by US and Canadian fighter jets in the Alaska Air Defense Identification Zone is part of a broader effort by Moscow and Beijing to test US military readiness. This collaboration extends to intelligence operations, with sophisticated technology being used from positions in Cuba to collect data across the Americas. In the realm of energy, Russia and China are deepening their cooperation. Russian President Vladimir Putin highlighted the significant development of energy projects, including new units at Chinese nuclear power plants. Furthermore, the two nations are considering a joint research base on the moon, marking a new frontier in their strategic partnership. Roscosmos chief Dmitry Rogozin confirmed mutual steps towards this goal, reflecting the broader ambitions of their collaboration in space exploration.
Listen, thank you so much for joining me. Get your CEUs. That's why I'm doing this. I get that continuing education credits. I hope you learned something today. Contact me on LinkedIn. Contact me on Matthew Jett Hall at Twitter. Hope to hear from you soon. Hope you enjoyed the program. Feedback's welcome, and God bless you wherever your final destination may take you.